गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी डिस्कस अबाउट द लेक्चर दैट इज अल्फा डीके। अल्फा डीके इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ एमिशन ऑफ अल्फा पार्टिकल्स फ्रॉम डिसइंटीग्रेशन ऑफ रेडियो एक्टिव न्यूक्लियाई। सो दिस न्यूक्लियाई डिसइंटीग्रेटेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, इन दिस अल्फा पार्टिकल इज एमिटेड। इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ अल्फा डीके द एटॉमिक नंबर डिक्रीज्ड बाय 2 यूनिट्स एंड मास नंबर डिक्रीज्ड बाय 4 यूनिट्स। The alpha decay process takes place only for heavy nuclei A greater than 200. The alpha particles are helium nuclei. Alpha particles is emitted from the radioactive nuclei. Before emission, alpha particles exist inside the nucleus. Classical physics fails to explain alpha decay. Quantum mechanics successfully explain alpha decay. Alpha spectrum explains the existence of discrete energy levels in a nucleus. Now discuss range of alpha particles. So the distance through which an alpha particles travels in a substance before absorbed in it is called range of alpha particle in that substance. The range depends on the initial energy of alpha particles there, and second one, the ionization potential of the gas. The range and also depends on the nature and pressure of the gas. So these alpha particle depends on these three factors. Giger found that the range is proportional to the cube of the velocity, that is r proportional to v cube. So now remove the proportionality, r is equal to a v power cube, where a is constant. It is a Geiger law. Another Geiger discovered that the energy of the alpha particle is directly proportional to the square of the velocity, that is e proportional to v square. Now remove the proportion, so from this v proportional to square root e, therefore remove the proportionality, v is equal to a suffix 1 e power 1/2. So substitute equation 2 in equation 1. So therefore r is equal to a into a1 e to the power of 1/2 whole power 3. So that is equal to r is equal to a1 3/2. So a, so sorry, a1 3, so into e power 3/2. So where b is equal to a cube, where a b is equal to a1 cube, so constant. So equation 3 is called, is also called Geiger law. R is equal to b e power 3/2. So this is a Geiger's law. So Geiger's law two types. The here the range is proportional to cube of the velocity, and the range is proportional to e power 3/2. These two are called Geiger's law. Now discuss another that is a Geiger Nuttall law. So Geiger and Nuttall, two scientists, so measured the range of alpha particles emitted by different radioactive elements and found that there exists a relation between the ranges and decay constant of the elements. So it is log base e is equal to a plus log base e r. So where lambda is called disintegration constant, a and b are constants for the given series. This relation is called Geiger-Nuttall law. Geiger-Nuttall law means the relationship between the decay constants and range of alpha particle for different radioactive substances. So this relation is called Geiger-Nuttall law. So Geiger-Nuttall law, so the graph is plotted between log base e lambda and log base e r for different alpha emitters in the three radioactive series, that is radium series, thorium series, actinium series. So three parallel lines are obtained as shown in graph. So from graph these lines have different intercepts on log base e r axis. So this indicates that a is the constant a is different for different series. So the range different for different series, while the value of b is same for all series. The b here b represent the slope of the these series, and b is the slope b is same for all series, but a is different for different series, because so these three series intercept on log r shows different a values. So and a value is different for different series, and b value, and that is slope, is same for all series. So according to relation, so that isn't here, that is integration. So that is integration depends on range. So from the relation, log disintegration constant depends on range. So according to relation, when the disintegration constant is high, the range is also high. Since the range depends on the energy, so that is R is, so that is the range depends on energy. R is equal to B e to the power of 3/2. The energy, the range depends on the energy. So we conclude that radioactive elements of large decay constant emit high energy alpha particles. So from this, if the range is high, means range of alpha particles is high for high decay constants. If the alpha particle range is high, means they have high energy and also high disintegration constant values. If the disintegration constant is low, then the range is also low. Range is low means low for short range of alpha particles. So this is the conclusions of Geiger's Nuttall law. Range of alpha particle is high for high disintegration constant values, corresponding to the short half-life of radioactive substances. Means the disintegration, the reciprocal of half-life period of radioactive substance is inversely proportional to decay constant. Decay constant to low value means high half-life period. Disintegration constant to high means low half-life period, short half-life period. So the range of alpha particle high for high energy alpha particles or high range alpha particles, then its half-life period is low. So this is the conclusion from Geiger's Nuttall law. Thank you, students. Now see the answer from starting to ending. Students, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you, students. Don't forget to subscribe my channel.